I came from a tradition of making pause tapes. If you heard of a piece, you'd have to record it, rewind it, get that piece back, record it, rewind it, get that piece back, record it, rewind and get that, like, for hours and hours. So the SP-1200, once I saw that shit, I was like, fuck all that.
Back in the 90s, you know, I was married to the SP-1200. You know what I'm saying? You gotta get every element to the beat in 10.2 seconds. So what I did was put the record on 45. You know, and played it faster. Then things slowed it down in here. Boom, bap, that's it. I don't care what's new out. There's no better machine in the music industry.
For real.
Lost professor taught me things that got me to another level. The way he's truncate beats, he was like, and he was doing it almost like he was doing a magic trick. And I would just stare at him, just like, damn, how do you do that? He taught me how to take it to that level. And the SP-1200 had the littlest bit of sampling time, but I like the limitations so that you're forced to be creative with that little bit of time and still make an ill-ass beat.
It's not just sampling loops and big chunks. It's taking a note, maybe two notes. You add strings, you add horn hits. You had little nuances that people don't even pay attention to.